let's take a look at an example of inference on the slope in simple linear regression. Recall our simple linear regression model. Beta 1, a parameter representing the true slope, is an important quantity here because it gives us a lot of information about how y and x relate. For example, if beta 1 was equal to 0, then this term would drop out, and y and x would have no linear relationship. So inference procedures on the slope are very common in practice. Here's an example we looked at previously. 16 females received a score on the empathic concern scale and had pain-related brain activity measured. And this is our empathic concern scale, x, and here's our activation level in the pain centers of the brain, and that's a y. And the main point of interest in this study was simply seeing if there was strong evidence of a relationship between these two variables. It certainly looks like there's an increasing trend here, and we could fit a line through these points. So let's go ahead and do that using our least squares approach. Here's the output from the statistical computing package R for this problem. Output for different statistical software often looks very, very similar to this. And what we're interested right off the get-go here is getting our least squares regression line. This column gives us the estimates of the parameters beta naught and beta 1, and we use those in our least squares regression line. So it looks like there's an increasing trend, but we want to investigate that further with a little statistical inference. What can we say about the true value of the slope beta 1? First, we might be interested in constructing a confidence interval for beta 1. So let's say here we wanted a 95% confidence interval for the parameter beta 1. If you recall, to construct a confidence interval for beta 1, we take our best estimate of beta 1, which is beta 1 hat, and we add and subtract the margin of error, which is made up of a t value. In this case, it's going to be t.025 because we're doing a 95% confidence interval, and we multiply that by the standard error of beta 1 hat. These values are found in the output. Beta 1 hat is found right here as 0.03454, and its standard error, the standard error of beta 1 hat, is found right next door at 0.01225. So now we need to find the appropriate t value, and to do so we need the degrees of freedom. And the degrees of freedom in simple linear regression are n minus 2, and we had 16 observations in this data set, so there's 16 minus 2, or 14 degrees of freedom. So the value of beta 1 hat is given in the output as 0.03454, and then we're adding and subtracting the appropriate t value. And if we go to our table with 14 degrees of freedom, or if we use statistical software, we'd see that this value is 2.145. And we multiply that by the standard error, 0.01225. If we carry out those calculations, we would see that the 95% confidence interval for beta 1 to 3 decimal places is 0.008 and 0.061. We can be 95% confident that the parameter beta 1 lies within this interval. One point to note is that this interval does not contain 0, and in fact this entire interval lies to the right of 0. So this interval is giving us some evidence that beta 1 is actually greater than 0. Or in other words, we have some evidence here that as our explanatory variable x increases, our response variable y tends to increase. But it might be of interest to us to carry out that line of thinking a little bit more formally with a hypothesis test. Suppose we want to test the null hypothesis that beta 1 is equal to 0, and we feel that a choice of alpha of 0.05 is reasonable in this setting. And I'm going to say let's use a two-sided alternative here, because we're interested in a difference in either direction. And there's nothing really indicating that a one-sided alternative is more appropriate, so let's go with the two-sided alternative as a bit of a default. The test statistic is a t-test, and the t-statistic is equal to our estimator of beta 1, which is beta 1 hat, minus the hypothesized value, which is 0, over the standard error of our estimator. And in this case, that works out to 0.03454 minus the hypothesized value of 0, over the standard error, which is 0.01225. And that equals, to two decimal places, 2.82. Wait a minute, that is also given right here in the output. So we didn't actually have to calculate that because that's given in the output. And if we wanted the p-value, we would draw out our t-distribution with the appropriate degrees of freedom, which is 14 in this case, and we would say our test statistic falls out here at 2.82, and since it's a two-sided alternative, we would simply take the area out here in the tail beyond the test statistic and double that, so our p-value is double this area. And we can go to statistical software or use a table or what have you, but luckily for us, that is also given in the output right up here. So the p-value of this test is equal to 0.0136. And the p-value is less than the given alpha level of 0.05. So we can say the evidence against the null hypothesis is significant at 0.05. There is strong evidence that beta 1 actually differs from 0. But what does that mean in the context of this problem? In the context of this problem, it's saying that what we see here was very unlikely to have occurred due to chance alone, and that there is very strong evidence that this increasing effect that we see here is a real one, and that as empathic concern scale score increases, the activation level in the pain centers of the brain tends to increase. We have strong evidence of a real relationship between these variables. If we so desired, we could carry out similar inference procedures on the intercept. And actually, the computer does that for us right here in this line. For instance, that p-value is of the test of the null hypothesis that the true intercept, beta naught, is equal to 0. It's just as easy to carry out those inference procedures on the intercept as it is on the slope. It's just usually of much more practical interest to carry out inference procedures on the slope. That tests the more interesting questions for us in the vast majority of practical situations.